All right, folks. Welcome back. Welcome back, Chris Garlock, Michael Redmond with, if I'm not mistaken, is this game 9, Michael? I'm getting a little confused here.
It's game number 10.
Game number 10. Oh, my gosh. We are
in game number 9, we had Meng Tailing, and that was a game where the operator misclicked.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Yeah. But wait a minute. Isn't this the same player?
Yeah, that's right. It's Meng Tailing again. Maybe he was sort of hyped by the fact that he almost won that game.
I know, so close.
And so he got another chance. In fact, he's a player who played a total of 5 times against AlphaGo in this series. So he got a lot of games. He was working at it. I think you have to sort of just hang in there in the waiting list because there were a lot of people who wanted to play their games. I think there was a timing effect of just jumping in when you get the chance.
Excellent. Let's take a look.
So this is in this game, actually, Meng Tailing is going to do fairly well. He's going to have close to 50% winning percentage quite well into the game. So he's not making any big mistakes. You can see that now the human player has black. He's already trying out the AlphaGo opening. So this is the opening we've seen a number of times AlphaGo playing with black. Mm-hmm. But it's the human player trying it on AlphaGo. He's playing it to see how he should have played, because Meng Tailing was playing this variation, and he got into this thing, and very quickly AlphaGo took the lead. So he's trying it out, and he wants to see how AlphaGo is going to respond. AlphaGo just plays a corner enclosure. And it turns out the corner enclosure here is probably more important. Like, even if white plays this Kakari, white's not going to follow it up with the extension. White would follow it up with maybe with a corner enclosure now, or like this move that I really like. This move is also a very popular move.
Yeah.
Obviously, at this time in history, just a few years ago, but no one knew about this move, basically. It's a move that was almost never played. So AlphaGo plays the Shimari, and black plays a Kakari here. That's okay. Like, black could have played on the upper side or in the upper right corner. Any move there would have been okay. Black slides. Now, this is probably slightly bad, but, you know, it's the move that we played at the time again. Nowadays, if I had black now, I would probably be thinking of playing this move, which you can find, and you can actually find this in my AI Joseki playlist. So this is a move that I've commentated on about, and it's a modern Joseki that was helped by AIs. So this is what we might play now, but obviously we didn't have that knowledge at the time. Like this, in this case, you have to think of white playing a honey on top or playing a honey underneath, and it gets very complicated. So I'll talk more about that in the book, I guess. It's
okay.
If I talked about it now, we have another of those hour-long videos or something like that. So
I'm not going to do that here.
So I think that I would be playing here. Otherwise, a modern game, some players might be playing the attachment or something like that. Sliding is probably not played, just because it doesn't have so much impact on white. White can play away now. And so white plays. Now, this is unusual. This is not what a computer program would suggest now. And I think it's sort of unique to this version of AlphaGo, just to master. Like, usually, you see AI suggesting this. And for instance, this kind of thing could fall. Like if black plays here, there's all sorts of things can happen. For instance, this is sort of the version of this Joseki that I sort of like, where white gets to play an extra move towards the upper side. And so black is getting the corner territory, but white is getting a nice position on the upper side. So basically, in this whole exchange in the upper left corner, the functioning stone that white got as an addition is that mark stone. White sort of got that one move for free. Of course, the payment was that black's corner is very much solid compared to just the two stones that it started with. But black has got a better position there. But that mark stone that white got on the upper side is an extra move that white got out of that exchange there. So I sort of like this for white. In any case, these are moves that we would be seeing now. But surprisingly enough, AlphaGo was not playing it yet. And this is maybe like the only time I see this move, even in computer play so far. So it's pretty unique. Black kicks and extends. So this makes sense. But now white plays this. So you can see that AlphaGo is edging towards the idea of playing this attachment against the 4-4 point. But it doesn't really play it until later series. A later series like in the AlphaGo versus AlphaGo series of 50 games that came out about 6 months later. I think it was slightly different than this version. And it developed a little bit more. But at this point, it does play once here. Now, Black answers this way. Black could have played a honey on either side. There's a lot of... The difference is rather subtle, so I won't go into that here.
Right.
But this is really exciting. This is a point where it would have been slightly better maybe for Black to push here. And because of this stone on the upper side, White cannot really attack the corner yet. For instance, if White plays here, it's just going to fail. This Black stone is in a point that restricts White's movement, and White cannot accomplish much here. So White will just move to the right here, and this is the suggested variation, which is about even. This would have been a lot better than the game for Black, but just a couple of points maybe. But when Black plays here and White plays here, this is slightly better for White, just because White is sort of taking control of the upper side. The fact that White has the advantage in this local fight here in the upper left part of that side means that the weakness that White started out with was the fact that this position here, these three stones in the upper side, White was overextended. So there was a weakness that White started with. And what White is accomplishing here with this local fight in the upper left part is that by taking the initiative in the upper left, White is going to erase that weakness that White had on the upper side. So that's the what you might say is White's local goal in this fight. And I find it fascinating that AlphaGo plays in ways that I can describe like that, because I know that the computer programs don't think about it the same way as we do, in making little plans like that. But it in fact, it's working in the same way, I think. So White cuts here. This is a really interesting timing for White to cut. I guess AlphaGo really wanted to play this cut. This was actually a chance for Black to play on this side and sacrifice the corner. If I was playing Black, I would have chosen this variation. Even then, White can capture the two Black stones in the corner, but Black gets a very nice thickness and the initiative to build on the left side. I sort of like this for Black. I think Black has probably a slight advantage still. Mm. And Black is supposed to have an advantage at 6.5 points. So it's not that I'm criticizing AlphaGo's play.
Sure.
I think it's, but the Black is still keeping his advantage at this point. Black answered here, but this is the kind of thing that happens in a lightning game. You have to remember that they're playing on the internet and they don't have much time. So the human players just sort of, with this move in the corner, answering there on the second line, Black is just keeping the status quo because he thought he was okay to start with. So Black cuts here on the fifth line and then saves the three stones with this. A very reasonable sequence. Black isn't really doing anything very bad at this point. The computer programs that I use to study the game, they give White a slight advantage. Like White has something like a 52% winning percent. And that's something that even now I would not notice in a game. I don't think even top professionals notice that kind of difference, just a couple of percent. It's like it's dead even as far as a human player is concerned. White pushes through. With this, White has a completely living shape. And Black, since Black is connecting on the first line here, it means that these three white stones are pretty strong. So like even if Black plays here, White will have no trouble dealing with that with something like this. White does have all these forcing moves in this area. Sorry, these three moves, I would say. All of these forcing moves that will give White a lot of flexibility in handling that. Again, you see that Black is playing what was then the normal move, where nowadays people would be thinking about an attachment here. So that's where the game has changed after AI. And White starts building in the center. This is where the game is going to start to be looking good for White, actually. But still, if Black had played here, Black would have still been only a few percentage down, just a couple of points maybe. So Black would have been winning by several points on the board, maybe had trouble giving Komi, but if black had played like this and just invaded the lower left corner, this variation is not so bad for black. But the moment black plays the sliding move here, this was slow. So we're going to see white pulling ahead here, closing off the center. And then when white, when black peeps now,
oh man,
this was too late because white just takes on the corner. And is sacrificing the cornerstone, but white has this magnificent shape towards the center. Black cut here. The ladder does favor black, but black has to go back to the corner at this point. So at this point, the game is looking good for white. So, something like 65% for white. So this would not be finished for human players. It would still be fightable, but it would be a difference that we would notice. At least I, at this point, even I would notice that white has an advantage. And it turns out that Katago thinks that the game is pretty close before Komi. So white has a whole Komi to win by. So the game is pretty much over, I guess.
Wow. And it's interesting, Michael. I was just noticing that both of the moves that kind of put black in trouble were those slides.
Sliding on the second line. Just being those moves on the second line, we've always known that second line is not big. But there are certain moves that we've sort of that have functioned up till now, until we started using computers to analyze them. The second line is just bad. We've learned that. We're still learning. We're still in the process of learning that, I think.
And AlphaGo demonstrates it by simply ignoring it.
Yes. That's the best response, I guess.
It like really
if you answer it, it becomes a functioning move.
Exactly. All right, folks, again, we're just working our way through all 60 of these amazing games. Michael is focusing in on the key points, and then in volume 2 of AlphaGo to Zero, we will get more into the details and probably come up with some more things that we haven't thought of yet, but something to look forward to. Thanks, Michael, and thanks for watching.